morning, everyone. Students, today we are going to start our chapter number 7, Animals, Living and Surviving. Okay, now this is the last chapter of our first term. Okay. So let's start our chapter. If we talk about animals, my dear students, you have seen so many types of animals in your surroundings. You all have seen, okay? You have seen birds, you have seen fishes, you have seen your earthworm or other kind of worms. You have seen snakes also. These are the different kinds of animals. If we talk about some of the examples, like if we talk about earthworm or other type of worms, and if we talk about our birds, if we talk about fishes, yes, students, you all know about these animals, like some of these animals have backbone. You all know about the backbone. The human beings, we also have backbone, and some of the animals do not have backbone. And based on this, the animals, they can be divided into two main categories. Yes, animals can be divided into two main categories. Which main categories? Vertebrates and invertebrates. Vertebrates and invertebrates. Students, the animals that are having backbone. Animals that are having backbone, they are called vertebrates. Having backbone. Okay. And the animals which do not have backbone, they are called invertebrates. Do not have backbone. Yes, the animals can be divided into two main categories. Okay, vertebrates and invertebrates, and the animals, those are having backbone, they are called vertebrates, and the animals, those are not having backbones, or the animals that do not have backbone, they are called invertebrates. Okay, and students, you all know about the invertebrates, like insects, worms. Yes, these animals, they do not have backbone. Okay, and students, about 90% of all the animals are invertebrates, means animals without backbone. Okay, the 90% of the total animals are invertebrates. Invertebrates means the animals that are not having backbone. Like insects, earthworm, these are the different kinds of invertebrates. So let's start all about the vertebrates. You all know that the animals having backbone are vertebrates. Okay? And these are further divided into 5 main groups. Okay? Which 5 main groups? Fishes, then reptiles, amphibians. Yes, fishes, reptiles, amphibians, birds, and mammals. These are the 5 main groups of vertebrates. Okay, so now let's discuss about these 5 groups one by one. So we will start with fishes. Yes, we will start with fishes. Yes, fishes. fishes are the animals that live in water. Fishes live in water and they lay soft shell eggs. Yes, students, fishes lay soft shell eggs. Okay, for example, goldfish, salmon. Yes, goldfish, salmon, starfish, these are the different kinds of fishes. Okay, yes, what are the fishes? Fishes are the animals or are the type of vertebrates that live in water and they lay soft shell eggs. Yes, students, the example of fishes, goldfish, salmon, starfish, these are the different kinds of fishes. Okay, then our next group, next type of vertebrates are reptiles. Yes, reptiles are the types of vertebrates that crawl on the land. Yes, reptiles are the animals that crawl on the land. Okay, yes, and these reptiles, they lay hard shell. They lay hard shell eggs. Okay, and the reptiles have, they have dry and scaly skin. They have dry and scaly skin, and this can protect the reptiles. Okay, and example of reptiles, crocodile. Like crocodile, lizard, these are the reptiles. Okay, so what are reptiles? Reptiles are the type of vertebrates that crawl on the land. Okay, and they lay hard shell eggs. Okay, and the reptiles have dry and scaly skin, for example, crocodile, lizard, etc. Okay. And students, now we will discuss about the next type of vertebrates, that are amphibians. Yes. Students, like I told you, fishes live in water. And the reptiles, they crawl on the land. And amphibians are the next type of vertebrates that live both on land and in water. Yes, you all know about the frog. Frog can live in water as well as on land. So, frog is an example of amphibian. Okay? And the amphibians lay soft shell eggs. Clear to everyone? For example, frog. Frog is an example of amphibian that live in water as well as on land. Okay. So students, next type of vertebrates, so the next group of vertebrates is birds. Yes. Birds are the type of vertebrates. Those have wings and the birds can fly with the help of those wings. Birds can fly with the help of wings. Okay? And the birds lay hard shell eggs. Yes, birds can fly with the help of wings. Okay, and their body is covered with the feathers. The body of the birds is covered with the feathers, and the birds lay. They lay hard shell eggs. The birds lay hard shell eggs. Okay, for example, pigeon crow sparrow etc. These are the examples of the birds. Okay, so what are the birds? Birds are the type of vertebrates that can fly. Okay, and the birds lay hard shell eggs. For example, pigeon, crow, sparrow. Okay, these are the different examples of the birds. Now, the last group of vertebrates, mammals. Yes, mammals are the type of vertebrates that give birth to their young ones. Mammals give birth to their young ones. Okay, and they have hair on their body. External ears. Yes, mammals have hair on their body and external ears. For example, whale. Yes, whale is also an example of mammals because whale can give birth to their young ones. Whale, cows, dogs, human beings. Etc. These are the different examples of the mammals.